In this video, we are going to see how a freelance developer works and how software companies work. Let's say you are a freelance developer and you create websites for your clients. And you get a new client who says, I want to create a website that looks like this and has these colors, these buttons, etc. So what you do is create everything the website needs on your computer. All the files, the programs, the code that the website needs, you will write it on your computer and you check how it looks in a browser. When the website is ready, you can show it to the client, and if they are happy with it, you can put the website on a server. Now, any user on the internet can go to the website and they will see what you have created. If you want to learn more about these files and programs, you can check the video in the pinned comments down below. So now the website is there and everything is perfect. People are using it and maybe we don't have to change anything for a long time. But if the website is going well, our client will probably ask for changes, like removing some buttons, changing the images, etc. So we make these changes on our computer, we change the code that we had for this website, and we show it to our client. And when they're happy, we put it on the server. We change the files and programs that were there before, and we put these new ones. And when the users check the website again, they will see the new content. This is fine, but what happens if there are thousands of people using it? Maybe we don't want to put something there directly, because we could have an error in our code. This is why development servers exist. So now we are going to have two servers. One is going to be our development server and the other will be our production server. When our client asks for changes, we first put the new website on the development server and tell them to connect to that server to see it. They check how the website looks and make sure that everything is correct. And if they're happy, we can now put the new version on the production server and all users will be able to see this new version of the website. This is how you create software professionally, using a development server, also called dev server, and a production server, or prod. Now that we understand how a single person works, let's see what happens if there are multiple people. One option is that we are several programmers working on the same website. In that case, each programmer will make changes to the website on their computer and then they will put that new code on the development server. In future videos, we are going to talk more on how several programmers can work as a group on the same code. Also, on our team, there may be a person called the tester who is in charge of reviewing the changes that we make. So, in addition to our client, the tester will constantly be checking that the website on the development server works correctly and we didn't make any mistakes. If they find an error, we need to change the code in our computer and put it in the development server again, until the tester is happy. And now we can put it on the production server. In addition to the tester, we can have a designer, who is a person that will talk to the client, and when the client asks for changes, the designer creates a new version for the website, and if the client likes it, they will then pass the design to the programmers so that they can change the code until it looks just like the design. And then it goes to the dev server. The tester checks that it looks good, we show it to the client, and if they like it, we can put it in the production server. And we can also have a manager, like a project manager or team leader, who will be in charge of making sure that this whole process works correctly. This is the general structure of a development team that is working on a project. In this example, it was a website, but it could be a video game, an app, or any other project. The process of updating the code in the servers is called deploying. We can deploy to development or deploy to production. As we add more people to the team, the roles may become more and more specialized. If we have several programmers, some may work only on the backend, others only on the frontend, and others can be full stack and work on both. If you want to know what is backend and what is frontend, you can check the video in the pinned comment below. And we can also have programmers that focus on making sure that the whole process of updating the servers with code works correctly. This role is usually called a DevOps engineer or CI/CD. If the project we are working on is very large, we can have several development servers and several production servers. And there are also support engineers, which will talk to our users and collect the errors that they see on the website. This is an overview of how a development team works. Teams can have different sizes, but this is a common configuration. And a bigger company can have several of these teams running at the same time. So it will be the same structure, but for different projects. If you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe. And if you want to learn more about servers, you can click on this video.